Let us begin with a beautiful verse in the Quran where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Isra, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. And I beg your attention, for these verses are not just there like that, they have deeper meaning than what you think. In fact, the more you read them, the more you understand that there is deeper meaning in them. Allah says,
وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا إِلَّا إِيَّاهُ وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وبالوالدين إحسانا إما يبلغن عندك الكبر أحدهما أو كلاهما فلا تقل لهما أف فلا تقل لهما أف ولا تنهرهما وقل لهما قولا كريما واخفض لهما جناح الذل من الرحمة وقل رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا.
Allah says, and your Lord has strictly commanded you that you worship none other but Him. That you worship none other but Him. And to be absolutely good towards your parents. Ihsan. Ihsan means more than just good. It means to exert absolute goodness even at the times when you are struggling and don't feel like doing it. Continue. No matter how old they become in age, if you live and they live to the time when you see them grow old and frail, then never in all these years dare to even be bad to them, as little as pronouncing a sound of oof towards them. Don't even say oof towards them. And do not talk to them harshly. Tanharhuma. Do not talk to them in a rough manner, in a harsh tone. Allah's not even saying the words, He's saying the tone, the sound of your voice. Don't even talk with a harsh tone, a rough tone. وَقُلْ لَهُمَا قَوْلًا كَرِيمًا. But remember, always choose the most generous and beautiful words to say to them. And lower the wing of humility towards them out of mercy. Out of what? Mercy. Not respect, not kindness, but mercy, because the word rahmah has deeper meaning than kindness and respect. And say, O my Lord, give them mercy the same way they gave me mercy as they raised me from when I was a child. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَضَى. Qada is used when a judge rules in a court. Once he puts the hammer down, no one can go against it. The police come and take you. وَقَضَى رَبُّكَ. Your Lord has decreed. There is no one can go against it. That you worship none other but Him and to be absolutely good towards your parents, brothers and sisters. Did you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the two together in one sentence? In one sentence. Like there's no full stop between worshipping Allah alone and being good towards your parents in absolutes. There's no full stop. The only difference between the worship of Allah alone and the dutifulness towards parents is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the worship of Allah alone in the same sentence before mentioning the dutifulness towards parents. That's the only difference, because in the Arabic language, in one sentence, whatever you mention before another, it means it's a sequence. This is more important than that. That's the only difference. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the worship of Allah alone, then follows it by being dutiful towards the parents. Why? The scholars say, because the origin of life, the origin of your existence is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala originally. And the secondary origin is from your parents. In other words, you came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through His creation of Adam alayhi salam. And thereafter, until the end of time, your creation is from your parents. So as though Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is making a connection between His creation of us and the status of parents in your creation from them. Yani Ibn Abbas says, the most important after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger are your parents. Because this is the origin of your life. My brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah says, lower the wing of humility towards them out of mercy. And I explained, why did Allah say mercy, not respect? And why did He not mention out of love or out of kindness? Because mercy plays a different role in life. Rahmah means when somebody does something bad towards you, takes your right away, and they deserve in normal circumstances to be punished. Here, the only thing that will save that person is not rights, this for that, not justice, not kindness, not respect. It is mercy, rahmah. Mercy is when someone does something wrong towards you and takes your right, and they deserve in normal circumstances to be punished in the court of law, in justice. But instead you exercise mercy and you pardon them. Without even any apology, without taking your right back, you just let them go. Allah mentioned this towards the parents. Why is it that our Quran and Sunnah concentrate so much about the rights of parents more than what it mentions about the rights of children? Did you realize that? If you look into the Quran and look into the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you will find numerous ayat, numerous ahadith, which reminds the children to respect and obey and be good towards their parents more than what you will find about parents giving their rights to their children. A young person may ask, why is this emphasis so much about parents? You know? I'll tell you why. Because Allah created the parents with an instinctive nature. They can't help it. An instinctive nature to love their children. They will put their lives at stake for their children. They will sacrifice everything they have for their children. Even when they're angry at their children and they ground them or punish them, it is only because of their intense love for them, because they don't want them to fall. Especially the mother, and then the father. Except in very isolated situations. The mother and the father will give everything they have for their children. There is another verse in the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
وَوَصَّيْنَا الْإِنسَانَ بِوَالِدَيْهِ حَمَلَتْهُ أُمُّهُ وَهْنًا عَلَى وَهْنٍ وَفِصَالُهُ فِي عَامَيْنِ أَنُشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ إِلَيَّ الْمَصِيرُ وَإِن جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِي مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَلَا تُطِعْهُمَا وَصَاحِبْهُمَا فِي الدُّنْيَا مَعْرُوفًا.
Surah Luqman, verse 14. Allah says, and we commanded man, the human being, to be dutiful towards his parents. His mother carried him agony and pain upon agony and pain. And she went through labor and then breastfed him or her for 2 whole years. Behold, thank me and thank your parents, and to me you will return. And if your parents strive in jihad, jahadak, they strive with all their might to make you make partners with me, disbelieve in me, in ways which you have no knowledge of or which I have not commanded you to do so, then do not obey your parents if they do that. However, still maintain your duty of kindness towards them. Live with them on good terms. In this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying something remarkable. Allah says, we command you to be good towards your parents, and then He mentioned your mother. She carried you agony upon agony. This is in pregnancy. Your mother carried you for 9 whole months, and you kept getting bigger and bigger. It didn't get easier, right? The bigger you became, the heavier you became, and the more back pains and kidney pains, and then it comes with side effects, cholesterol and diabetes, and the body changes, and then she's never the same as before. It's all your fault. And we forget this. Yet even upon that, Allah gave her the strength. And then she breastfed you for 2 whole years or so. And then Allah says, if your parents strive to make you make partners with Allah, meaning they're non-Muslim, they're kuffar. Strive, meaning they're absolute kuffar. They hate the deen, they hate Allah. And not only are they telling you and advising you, they're telling you jahadak, meaning they'll strive in every way and probably even put you through torture to make partners with Allah. Allah says, merely, don't obey them. Don't torture them back. Don't abuse them. Don't spit at them. Don't hurt them. Don't hit them. Nothing. Just don't obey them. Don't listen to them about that. And still on top of that, even though they're telling you to make partners with me, Allah says, still live with them on good terms. This is the state of Ibrahim alayhi salam, as he said to his father when he strived to make him worship idols. Ibrahim alayhi salam maintained making dua for his father until his father died, and even after that, until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down a verse telling him, you're not allowed to make dua for your father to put him in paradise or forgiveness if he has chosen to die as a disbeliever. This was his choice. Now it is my right. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was rising the minbar one time, and the sahabas heard him say the following words, Ameen. Second time, Ameen. Third time, Ameen. When he finished, the sahabas asked him, Ya Rasulallah, what is the wisdom behind you saying Ameen, Ameen, Ameen? Benefit us. He said, Jibril alayhi salam came to me and said, may his nose be rubbed in dust. Whoever approaches Ramadan and Ramadan is finished and still their sins are not forgiven. I said, Ameen. Then he said to me, may his nose be rubbed in dust, meaning may be disgraced. Whoever hears my name being mentioned and doesn't send salutations upon me, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I said, Ameen. Jibreel making a dua against these people. He said, may his nose be rubbed in dust, in other words, be disgraced. Whoever reaches their parents in old age and still they did not be the cause for him or her entering paradise. I said, Ameen. You know what that means? It means one of the greatest opportunities of you entering paradise is your parents reaching old age while you are still living with them, or they are still living while you are around, and they die and they still could not make you enter paradise, meaning they died displeased with you. And this was the greatest opportunity for you to enter paradise because of them. You know, it's like someone bringing a pot of gold and places it in your bedroom and says to you, it's yours. All you have to do is take it. And it's in front of you and you say, I don't want it. I don't want it. So, in other words, may his nose be rubbed in dust. In other words, what a great loser this person is after having that opportunity. And this hadith occurs in Tuhfat al-Ahwad, and there is a similar hadith like it where the Prophet ﷺ repeated it 3 times. He said, how disgraceful they are, disgraced they are, disgraced they are, whoever. And Sahaba said, who, Ya Rasulullah, who? We beg of you, who? He said, the one who reaches his parents in old age and still he cannot enter paradise. And this hadith is in Sahih Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, he who is pleased to have his provision increased. You want to get wealthy? You want to have land? You want to have many houses? You want to be happy? Luxurious in life? He who wants this to be increased in his lifetime and his lifespan be extended, meaning you want to live longer and healthy and happy, then let him keep relations with relatives and kinship. Kinship means ar-rahim, which is the womb that resides in the mother, meaning everyone who is connected to the mother or the father, keep their relationships, and your parents are the first of them. Narrated in Sahih al-Bukhari and Riyad al-Salihin. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the creation, this hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. He created the womb, and the womb complained to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, saying, "Oh my Lord, I fear that people will cut me off." Then Allah said to the womb, "Would it satisfy you if I disconnect from myself anyone who disconnects you? And whoever connects you, I will connect them to myself." And the womb said, "I am satisfied, my Lord." Allah said, "Then let it be for you." In other words, if you want to be connected to Allah, then it is through your parents. It is not enough for a person to be praying and fasting and going to Hajj tens of times and giving da'wah out there to every person and people converting on their hands into Islam and them going out into jihad and them donating everything they have, and they die even on the battlefield in the best of ways while their parents are displeased with them. You will not enter Jannah. You will not enter Jannah, my brother and sister. A man came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, "Ya Rasulullah, I want to go on jihad with you. I want to sacrifice my life." It was a voluntary jihad. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, "Alaka um? Do you have a mother?" He said, "Yes, she's old in age." He said, "Who's looking after her?" He said, "I'm her only son." He said, "Burraha, go and be dutiful towards her. Is it Jannah that you are seeking through this jihad?" He said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah." He said, "Falzam qadamayha, go and serve her feet, for there is paradise." Unless it's compulsory jihad, it's a different story. There is another hadith by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, when he was translating or interpreting the ayah, "Anishkur li wa li walidayk," Allah says, "Thank me and thank your parents." He said, this means, if you thank Allah but not appreciate your parents, then your thanks to Allah will not be accepted. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said this hadith in Sahih al-Jami', he said, "The Lord is pleased with the pleasing of the parents, and the Lord is angry with him who angers their parents."